How you going, guys? Curtis from Cutting Edge Engineering. This is part two of our D10 blade tilt cylinder rebuild. We've got the barrel set up in the machine now. The material we got in for this is a 10¾ by 9¼ unhoned tube. So it's got a pretty rough surface finish on the inside. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to come in and face that. We've got to cut a steady band on it. I've then got to machine just a little bit of material back for the head flange. We'll then flip the barrel. I'll do the other end and put the weld prep on that ready to go. We'll take it out of the machine, we'll fit the head flange to it, we'll set that up on the rotator, we'll weld that out. After the welding's completed and it's cooled down, we'll put it back in the machine, I'll put in one of the big boring bars and we'll actually bore it out pretty close to size and then we'll finish it off in the honing machine. Thank you. knocking already.
Thank you.
Righto guys, we've completed the machining on our cylinder barrel now. We've pulled it out of the lathe, thrown it in our vertical honing machine. We've set it up and it's time to start honing. It's a dog toy. Thank you. Righto guys, so the barrel's been honed now. It's all honed to size, ready to go. We put the barrel back in the machine. So now we're gonna put our barrel end back on. I do it in the machine because I do have those alignment pins that I actually stamped into it. So it's quite easy to set up in the machine. So we'll get that up in the machine, get the tailstock up against it. We'll get everything in alignment, check measurements, make sure everything's right, and we'll tack that in place. Righto guys, a lot of people have commented about tacking jobs in a lathe. It's something you can do, providing you do a few simple things. Turn off the machine, earth to the job. Don't earth straight to the bed of your machine. Don't earth to a chuck. Don't earth to anything like that. Earth straight onto the job. Tack the component or whatever you're doing. That's the only way to stop any earthing through any of your bearing in your headstock or your tailstock. You won't often see me put down a blanket on the bed. I do use anti-spatter spray and inox and stuff like that before I do any tacking. It's just one of those things you can do, just providing you take the right precautions and cover your bedways so you don't get any spatter or anything on them. We've got our bit of hollow bar cut. It's a 120 ID by 170 OD. The piece of material I wanted wasn't in stock, so this will have to do. So it's cut to length now. We're gonna machine 10 mil off the outer diameter to bring it down to 160 mil. We're gonna set up a steady rest on here and bore the inside to suit the end of the barrel. We'll then spin it, do the same thing on the other end, and then that's prepped ready to go on the barrel. Righto guys, so we've completed all the welding that needed to be done on the barrel for the time being. We're not going any further with it at the moment, as it can be one of four cylinders for a D10 dozer. It can be a left or a right on a D10R, or a left and a right on a D10T. The only difference between an R and a T is the mounts that go on the end of the barrel here and the pipework. If you remember the start of part one, this is actually a right-hand cylinder. We do have this one's brother outside, so we did actually buy them as a pair. So until we get that one in the workshop and up to this stage, this one's just going to remain the way it is. They are a pretty high turnover component, so if a customer calls us and needs a left, it'll only take about an hour and a half to put the clevis on the end, the handle and the mounts for the pipework, and assemble the cylinder for them. So keep an eye out for part three, where we're going to be doing a re-rod on the cylinder rod for this particular barrel. Righto guys, so we get them in unhoned that way, I said honed.
I think you said unhoned.
Did I?
Yeah.
Sounded like honed.
Just say it again.
So we did have to bore all that out. What are you doing?
Please try and focus here, because every time you turn, it's editing like the focusing. Right. Unless if you have to look at it, I'll move myself.
You can't move that quick. Alright, start again then.
Yeah, try and look here.
So, where was I going with that?
I don't know. Okay.
Fuck. First step we got to do is set...
You don't need to talk about what you're doing now. You've already said all that.
That's all I need to talk about, so that now we're going to get into it. Oh, fuck. 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 Oh, fuck. 10mm off the outer surface. Off the outer dot. We'll take it out of the machine. We'll then fit the, fuck's sake. We'll put a big, put a bit of hollow, after it's finished, fuck.
Okay.
Now turn down the outside, get a steady setup. We're gonna bore the inside, weld prep the ends.
Okay.
You were filming. See, I can say it when I'm not trying to do it. So we finished the honing on our barrel. I just hit the fucking barrel. Righto, so we're going to turn down the outside. Oh, tack. Is that it?
You end like you're going to keep talking.
Sorry?
Yeah. Oh.
Fuck's sake. Shit. Get in the bin. I actually got them in the bin.
Do you want to do it again?
Do it again.
It made it over there to the bin.
It actually went in the bin.
Go on. Go away. Go away.